So the next problem that we need to worry about is the problem of state estimation. And as we were just talking about a couple moments ago, we can make a POMDP into a kind of MDP by expanding out the state space. What we're going to do is consider what we call belief states. So the state that the decision maker is going to use in the context of a POMDP is going to be a belief state, B. And what a belief state B gives you is that if you tell me a state like S, belief state B of S tells us the probability that we're actually in state S at the current moment of time.
So B is a sort of like a state. Well, it's a belief state. So it's like what we did in the last example. It's kind of a vector. It's a distribution over states.
Yes, exactly. It's a probability distribution over states. Yes. And that's going to encode for us. It's going to retain for us the information about the history that might be important for decision making.
Oh, okay. So it gets us all the way back to the beginning. Okay, so B of S then. So B is just a vector and it's indexed by S, and S, instead of being an integer, is just a state.
Right.
Okay, that works. It's a probability distribution. All right, that makes sense. Okay.
So now what we need to do is figure out how this belief state gets updated as we take actions in the world.
Okay.
So the way we're going to think about that is we're in some belief state, we choose an action, the world gives us back an observation, and we need now a new belief state to be formed from that.
Okay. So that's exactly parallel to the, we were in a state, we took an action, then we got into another state.
Right. So what we really are doing here is we're building up a notion of a belief MDP. So we're going to turn the POMDP into a kind of MDP, specifically the belief MDP, where the states of the belief MDP are probability distributions over states of the underlying MDP in the POMDP.
Okay, sounds good. So an aside, Michael, is if reward is a function of state, which it sometimes is, so you should be able to use that to update your belief state.
Right. So in what we're going to be talking about, the reward is essentially not observed.
Mm-hmm.
But of course, in reality, if you have a learner that's in some environment and it's making observations and getting some reward back, it can actually, if it knows something about how that reward is being generated, it can use that as a kind of observation. And so we can essentially assume that the observation has whatever information might be in the reward in it.
Right. So, in fact, the observation is whatever sub-features you get to see plus the reward.
Yeah, I've seen some people write it this way, where you say that the reward is actually something about the observable. You can, you know, all the reward you get is extracted from what you observe. And so anything that you model in the POMDP as being reward relevant has to actually show up in the observation.
All right. That seems reasonable.
Right. Otherwise, you kind of can't learn if you can't observe it.
Right. That makes perfect sense.
All right. So what we need to do is derive how we get this probability distribution over states, B prime, from the old belief state, the action, the observation, and whatever quantities in the POMDP that we have. So what we need to figure out is, in this new belief state, after we've taken action A and seen observation Z, what is the probability that we're in state S prime? And so we're going to have to do some kind of probabilistic, inference or derivation to work that out.
Sure. We ought to be able to do that, right? Because we have all the quantities that we need in the POMDP, I think.
Well, that's the hope. So we want the probability of the next state, given that we're in a belief state, took an action, and made an observation. So can we manipulate this expression using the laws of probability to make sense out of it?
Sure.
That's a good answer.